In this illustration, we'll discuss about amplitude of a longitudinal wave. We are given that a sound wave of frequency 1 kHz propagating in air has pressure amplitude about 10 to power minus 4 atmosphere, and at an instant pressure at a specific point is maximum. We are required to find the particle's displacement at this point at this instant, and we are also required to find the displacement amplitude of the wave. So, here we know well that as displacement and pressure at a point in sound waves, we already studied that displacement and pressure at a point in sound waves vary with 90 degree phase difference. This implies at a point where P is maximum, and as these are sinusoidal variations, if P is maximum, this implies displacement at this point will be 0. Here we can write x equals to 0, because if x varies in sine function, pressure varies in cos function, so if p is maximum, the value of displacement will be 0. And we also use the pressure amplitude can be given as delta P naught is equals to 2 pi by lambda multiplied by AB, where A is the displacement amplitude and B is the bulk modulus, where B we write as gamma times P atmospheric, which we already studied in concept videos. If gamma is the ratio of specific heat, in normal cases bulk modulus of air can be taken as gamma P atmosphere. So, in this situation here, we can analyze the value of delta P naught is 10 to power minus 4 atmosphere, and this equals to 2 pi by lambda, and the value of lambda we can calculate as we know the frequency is 1 kilohertz. So, we can write the value of wavelength is C by N, and for a sound wave, if sound velocity is taken as 333 divided by frequency is 1000. So, lambda we can write as approximately 1 by 3 meter. So, we can substitute lambda as 1 by 3 meter times A multiplied by B, and bulk modulus we know it is gamma times atmospheric pressure, and air can be considered as a diatomic gas. So, in this situation, this can be written as 1.4 times the atmospheric pressure. Here, atmospheric pressure also gets cancelled out, and on simplifying, the value of displacement amplitude we are getting is 10 to power minus 4 divided by this 6 multiplied by 3.14 multiplied by 1.4. which is 3.79 multiplied by 10 to power minus 6 meter. That is the result of this problem.